Welcome, it's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here and you wanna find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more, well, and first make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
The mother is the one who gives and does not wait to receive in return for giving. She's the one who, no matter how much you try to do and offer her, she will not be able to return her favor to you, even as much as a small atom. The mother is the reason for your existence in this life and the reason for your success. She gives you from her blood and health to grow up healthy. She's your help in the world. A mother is different from other people. People give you anticipating the result, but the mother gives without limits and in abundance to her children without waiting for a return, thanks or appreciation. And if a person ever thought that he would return even a part of what his mother had done to him, he would not be able to. Her staying up for long nights, bearing all the burdens of her children's lives, her anxiety, fear, attention, and care makes it difficult or even impossible to return even a small part of her bounty. Charity to the mother has many manifestations, including ensuring the mother's satisfaction by complying with her commands and avoiding their prohibitions, in addition to keenness on humility to them in words and actions, and keenness to treat them softly. The children must also meet the necessary material needs and luxuries of the mother and father when possible. How many times have the father and mother preferred to give their child what he loves of food and drink and deprive themselves of what they need? One must show the feelings of love and respect for one's parents in front of people without shame. Not listening to the mother's words, ignoring her, and treating her badly lead to a very severe dilemma. If a person neglects his mother or treats her worse, this will lead to his downfall. That's exactly what happened with Mark. In a very simple village, a beautiful woman named Julia married her neighbor, Joseph, who worked as a farmer on his large farm. They lived a very happy life in the beginning, and they loved each other very much. Unfortunately, this happiness did not last long. Nothing lasts and nothing stays the same. Life is not static. Everything changes in one moment. The dreary day came when it was supposed to be the happiest day in Julia's life. Julia went to the doctor early in the morning because she was feeling sick and had an unusual headache. The doctor told her that she was pregnant and needed to rest. Julia was very happy with this good news. Julia and her husband, Joseph, wished they had a beautiful baby, and now Julia is pregnant. Julia thought of a creative way to tell her husband, Joseph, that she was pregnant, but fate never wanted that to happen. Husband Joseph is supposed to be back in the evening. Joseph went by his car in the morning. He travels to the city with fruits to sell in the shops, but Joseph had a tragic accident and died. Julia was shocked a lot after she learned that her husband had died and she was in a severe psychological state. But she helped herself for her next son to live a happy life because he had no guilt in always seeing his mother so sad. He decided to go to the farm instead of her husband, who died, and she worked on the farm in order to save money for her next son. It was a very tough job, and she spent most of the day on the farm with the scorching hot sunlight always coming to her face. She had no other solution or option to save money but to work on the farm. Finally, after 9 months, Julia gave birth to a very beautiful baby named John. John is a very beautiful child. She took great care of him and sacrificed for him. She always stays up nights to take care of him. He was often ill as she tried to ease the nation. She did not accept to marry a man so as to not upset her son, so she really sacrificed a lot for him. Years later, John has grown into a mature young man. John wanted to be a doctor since his childhood. Although the medical college is not easy to join because of the cost of money, his mother Julia helped him and gave him money to join the medical college and realize his beautiful dream. Indeed, John joined medical school and became a brilliant doctor. John married an arrogant girl named Anna. John loves Anna very much and hears all her words. He listens to her commands as if she were a witch to him. Love in life is very important, but not in a way that leads to failure. A person must balance the requirements of himself and his love. Anna takes advantage of John and takes advantage of his love for her. She knows very well that if she asks him for anything, he will achieve for her. This is never true. A person should think about what he's doing and focus on everything. And that's not everything or something is done as others desire at the expense of himself. Anna and her husband John live with his mother Julia. Mother Julia is very affectionate and treats her daughter-in-law Anna as if she were her own daughter. She loves her very much and sympathizes with her, but despite that, Anna hates her very much. Anna makes her mother-in-law Julia clean the house and wash the clothes. Julia is getting old and will not be able to do everything in the house, but Anna forces her to do the housework. Anna also did more than that. She always tells her husband John that his mom doesn't like him and wants to write the name of the farm in someone else's name. She lies and wants to make son John hate his mother so that he can kick her out of the house and so that his house and the farm are hers alone. Anna took advantage of John's love for her, and he would do what she told him to do. Anna told John that she could no longer stand Mother Julia in the house and said to him, "I don't want that old woman in the house. She bothers me so much. You should take your mother to the barn to live with the animals. I don't want to live with her. That bothers me so much." John's heart had become hard because of his wife Anna, as she influenced the formation of his character a lot, and he became a solid person. And the unexpected fool when John took his mother to the barn to live there, and she did nothing but was shocked a lot and said to him, "How do you do that to your mother? You sell your mother for your wife? I will never be satisfied with you. I will never forgive you. God will not forgive you, and he will not help you, never in your life." Mother Julia was very sad and did not believe what happened at all. She went to her old house to live alone there. John went to his wife Anna, but the big surprise is his discovery of his wife's betrayal. Anna cheated on him with another man. John came into the house and heard his wife Anna talking on the phone with another man. John hit Anna and divorced her on the spot. John experienced a difficult psychological state after that. John did not want to believe the bitter truth. He sees his wife Anna as an angel, but that's never the case. Anna just married John because he's a doctor and he's going to make a lot of money, and she's going to make him kick his mom out of the house so she can take the house and the farm for her alone. Anna's very greedy and never liked John. John lived a fake love story. John was very sad and thought of going to a psychiatrist. He wants to reconcile with his mother. John had great regret when he expelled his mother in order to please his unfaithful wife. He now wants to go to his mother, but he's ashamed of what he did to her. Julia's mother is also very sad and does not know what to do and is in a bad psychological state. She's still in shock and says to herself, "How did my son do that to me? How did he kick me out for that girl? I know she's not a good girl, and it will lead to his downfall." Indeed, everything Julia said happened, as if she knows everything. Really, moms are great people. When a mother says about a person in her son's life that they're a bad person, they really are. It's strange that mothers have different views, but they're proven correct. Now John wants to go to his mother to apologize to her and ask her forgiveness. Fate put John in a very difficult situation. Destiny is capable of doing strange things. Every day, the situations and people in our lives change. John went to the psychiatrist to prepare him psychologically to go to his mother because he could not because of his shyness and fear of her. The psychiatrist told him that he must have the courage to ask forgiveness from his mother and kiss her hands and head. John's very shy and went to his mother, and when Mother Julia saw him, she cried a lot and turned her face to the other side. John cried a lot and said with a sad voice, "I'm sorry, Mom. You're right about everything. Please forgive me. I was such an idiot. I'll never do that again. Forgive me, Mom." Then he kissed her hands and her head while she was crying, and the mother was crying a lot, and she didn't know what to say. She's just sad and said, "I wish I had died before you did." He told her, "Mom, I'm sorry. I was tempted by Satan. I didn't know how I did it. I'll be at your feet to do whatever you want, but I ask your forgiveness. Please forgive me." The mother is a very difficult position. She forgave him, though. They came home together and everything was fine. A person must follow his mother's orders and prefer her to anyone else. Failure to obey their mother leads to the big dilemma. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.